Ignorance is not bliss when it comes to raising children. Some things we take for granted can actually be harmful for a child's development. Watch until number one to see how even sitting can be dangerous. If this is your first time visiting our channel, don't forget to subscribe to The Things, and please give this video a big thumbs up. Today, we are showing you the things parents should never let their kids do. Giving tablets to toddlers. It's impossible to deny that the use of screens, from smartphones to tablets, has seriously altered our day-to-day access to information and how we socially interact. Screens have also impacted parenting, especially with regard to keeping children occupied. It may appear that handing a two-year-old a smartphone to keep them busy at a restaurant is an effective method of entertainment, but health professionals and psychologists have established several reasons why screens need to be limited for children under the age of three. At this time, a toddler's brain is in one of its most significant periods of growth, known as the critical period. Although an educational TV show streaming on a screen may seem like a harmless way of keeping a child occupied, it pales in comparison to the effects of a parent reading to their child. Instead, what may be considered an educational app or animated show is actually performing cognitive tasks for the child, thus weakening their own cognitive skills. In other words, tablets and phones make information too easy for children to understand, which actually prevents them from developing. Let them win. Playing games with children and witnessing their joyful celebration when they win makes every game worth playing. Though it may seem harsh, letting kids win every time they play a game is not as positive as you may think. There are several reasons why children being allowed to win at every game can be seriously damaging. Among the top reasons is the inability to teach children strategies to foster resilience. Sooner or later, children will encounter a situation when they lose, as this is a natural part of life. Not only will the impulse to sulk result in a sore loser attitude, it will prevent children from learning from mistakes and using them to build stronger strategies. Trying over and over again to get something right shows kids that they can become better over time. This instills motivation and determination that lead to successful habits in all areas of life as a child grows and matures. Kids also need to feel like their parent is in control. Eventually, all kids figure out when their parents are letting them win. Children need to feel taken care of, and even if it's a challenging lesson to learn, they want their parents to be in charge to set boundaries that ensure their safety. Alternative strategies include positive reinforcement and being a good role model, showing kids that winning is not all that matters. Have sleepovers. Children are told time and time again not to talk to strangers and to be careful and wary of who they trust. Constantly trying to protect your child can be harmful for their development, especially when social interactions are concerned. However, more and more evidence suggests that the innocent practices children were once encouraged to participate in are actually damaging and harmful. Sleepovers are an integral part of building relationships with friends, but studies suggest that sleepovers are not the innocent activity we assumed it to be. This item on our list is among the most controversial things parents shouldn't let their kids do. In fact, one New York Times blogger has consistently received both positive and negative feedback in response to his decision to forbid sleepovers. While many would argue that sleepovers are essential for bonding between friends, others suggest that they encourage harmful, even dangerous rituals. For example, truth or dare games or initiation practices can be traumatic and scary for children. Especially since so many kids are given cell phones, they lack the knowledge on what effect social media might have on others. Finally, another argument against sleepovers is the fact that if you are the parents hosting, you are held accountable for what occurs while the children spend the night. Do you think limiting sleepovers to family and very close friends is also limiting a child's ability to make more friends? Or is it a necessary step to protect children in today's society? Let us know. Let them be in charge. Letting kids be in charge is not always an issue that arises intentionally. We've all seen the unruly child run around the store and touch everything in their reach, not being stopped or even seen by their parent. Losing control over a child can happen pretty gradually and often arises from a parent's desire to be a friend to their child. While offering support and establishing open communication with your child as they age is an important part of bonding with a child, a parent needs to remain as the final decision maker. Social worker and blogger James Lehman suggests that there are four areas where parents need to call the shots: safety, health issues, performance, and preparation for adulthood. Lehman terms these hard issues and says that children need to feel protected by their parents and understand that they are in charge. This also helps foster respect as the child gets older, especially as a teen when they are in a developmental stage of individuation. Other issues, however, are ideal for negotiation and compromise. These are called soft issues. Soft issues include what kids want to wear, what they want to watch, or their hairstyle. One last thing to remember when making sure kids are never in charge is not arguing like they do. Instead, always shift the focus on the child and find another way to express anger rather than retaliating at your child in a fight. Doing so can make the child feel like their parent has lost control and they have the power to get away with what they want. go down a slide on a parent's lap. While the harmful use of iPads and smartphones made our list, it may be surprising that some much more traditional parenting practices can put your child in just as much risk. While heading to the park or playground is an amazing way to spend time with your child outdoors, some precautions still need to be taken. Among one of the most common playground injuries are small kids breaking legs by going down a slide on their parents' or caregiver's lap. What may seem as a way of protecting a child is in fact placing them at an increased risk. Studies show that children are at a much greater risk of injury if they go down a slide on an adult's lap. The force at which a grown-up descends on a slide is much faster than a child can on their own. In fact, on their own, it is very unlikely that a child will break or fracture a bone at all. On a parent's lap, however, if their foot or leg gets stuck on the edge of the slide, it is easy for a bone to be broken because of the accelerated force and speed of their descent. In other words, letting a child go down on a slide on their own and waiting for them at the bottom is the best way to ensure a trip to the park remains a fun and safe experience. Solve all problems with punishments. Timeouts are an easy go-to when kids are misbehaving, but it may not be the best way to teach them right from wrong, let alone prevent repeated bad behavior. The whole point of punishments is to help children learn that their actions have consequences and encourage them to think before they act. Unfortunately, punishments are often ineffective in this respect, as they don't help teach self-regulatory strategies, an essential part of maturing and learning from mistakes. Punishments don't help children learn a lesson about discipline and self-control. Positive reinforcement is much more effective. Interacting and playing with children on a regular basis allows parents the opportunity to praise and reinforce positive behaviors. Consistency is also very important when it comes to punishments. When behavior is inappropriate, kids need to be able to anticipate what the consequences for their actions will be, or else they are likely to repeat the behavior in the future. If bad behavior is consistently repeated, then consequences may not be an effective response. Learning to express concerns or issues through a calm conversation is a healthy skill for kids to learn to rely on in all future conflicts as well. Think money grows on trees. Money, unfortunately, takes a dominant role in our lives. Having children changes our approach to money, but this doesn't mean it doesn't involve them. Rather than hiding money from kids, taking time to consider how we talk about it can go a long way in creating healthy and positive money habits for kids. For example, dismissing the need of a budget is not a good way of ensuring kids learn the value of money and cost of things. While on a shopping trip, noticing the price of items and sticking to a pre-established budget is an easy way of introducing budgeting. Parents' decisions not to discuss money around their children is well-intentioned as an attempt to protect them and not to scare them. Instead, like with any other topic, teaching kids that talking and asking about money is a good thing encourages them to be more comfortable with learning about and discussing financial decisions as they age. Ideally, the goal is to make sure children don't feel uncomfortable about money. While worrying about finances is not healthy at an early age, feeling comfortable to ask questions and develop essential skills is always in the child's best interest. Stop them from playing with Lego. With studies constantly emerging with statistics accounting for the number of hours young children spend on screens, some toys may be temporarily forgotten. One toy that has not only remained popular and relevant since its existence is Lego. Following instructions or even just using imagination to turn individual parts into a cohesive structure helps children develop their creativity. In an attempt to make the building process more gender inclusive, Lego produced a line of Lego Friends, targeted specifically to girls. Lego Friends sold exceptionally well. The reason was because of the different choices shoppers, rather than kids, were making. This means that parents began to associate Lego as a product for girls as well as for boys when it was marketed as more of a girly product. Choosing toys based on gender can be harmful, as it suggests that some skills are developed based on gender and not on interest. Seeing as Lego keeps kids entertained for hours, promotes creativity and imagination, it has remained an important aspect of a child's development. Sitting in a W. While many adults work on finding remedies for spending so many hours seated in front of a computer, children can also suffer consequences for the time they spend sitting. The W position consists of a kid sitting with each leg positioned to the side and bent at the knee. This is a very common and comfortable position for kids to play in as it provides them with the stability they need. However, because of the positioning, range of motion is significantly limited as children aren't able to twist their bodies to access the toys around them. The problem with this seated pose is that it can cause serious health implications later in the child's life. Sitting like this repeatedly for too long a time can create a stiffness in hip and leg joints. This can result in difficulty running or jumping due to improper development of balance. What might just appear to be a cute frog-like pose can turn out to be potentially limiting for children's function both during playtime and down the road. Despite the overwhelming evidence and cautions by health professionals, parents have expressed their reluctance in correcting their children's chosen position while engaging in play, arguing that kids need to be kids. What do you think? Is it overprotective to worry about how kids are sitting? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And that's all for the 10 things parents should never let their kids do. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel to catch more videos like 20 parents whose sense of humor is better than their kids. Thanks for watching!